Welcome back. In this lesson, we're going to learn about the art history movement called pointillism. Now, most people call it pointillism, but it is also known as Neo-Impressionism. This is one of the main founding works of the movement, artwork by George Seurat named Sunday Morning in the Park. Very great painting. And this Neo-Impressionism was started by George Seurat. He was the founder. He was born on December 2nd, 1859, and died in 1891. He only had 31 working years and unfortunately died of sickness at a pretty young age. Now, Mr. Paul Signat, he was a big supporter and practitioner of Neo-Impressionism as well. He was born in 1863 and died in 1935. So he actually worked for quite a long time, 71 years. And he lived and worked in Paris. Now, the concept of Neo-Impressionism was to use small dots or points of pure hue color to make paintings. All right. Now, in the past, artists mostly used their palettes like this to mix the color on their palette and then apply it to the painting in one larger track of paint. And what was noticed that as when you put a couple colors next to each other, that those colors kind of reacted to each other. This is called visual mixing. So by placing small dots of color next to each other, each color that influenced the color next to it and the appearance of its neighboring color kind of changed it. If you wanted to have a real blue and you put red next to it, the two would kind of turn out to look purple. So the artist decided, well, what if we take like little dots of red, little dots of blue, put them all next to each other so that the blue really looks like blue, even though it might not have all the blue in it, and the color next to it really looks different. All right, so the idea being that color next to each other influences the overall color. So here's an artwork by Seurat. This is one of his final artworks that he made, entitled The Circus. And here's a close-up of the Sunday morning in the park, the man in that picture. And you can see all the little tiny dots of colors. He's got yellows and blues and pinks right next to each other that make up the face, make up the hair, make up the eyes, one little dot of green there. Okay, likewise, this other one on this side here by Signat, it is a little different in the sense that it's got smaller, like more refined dots. You know, he's got a variety of different kinds of pinks in here that kind of give the feeling of the texture and the shading of each of these pieces. And here in the sky, he's got a variety of different kinds of blues. He doesn't have such a jumble of different colors together like Seurat did. Now, both of these artists had different styles, even though they were working in the form of Neo-Impressionism. My favorite here is Henry Edmund Cross. He kind of combined Neo-Impressionism style with a little bit of fauvism and enhanced his colors. So you can see this again is a very different interpretation of Neo-Impressionism. It's almost bordering on fauvism, and of course I love that color combination, so I tend to make work in his style. He was born in 1856 and died in 1910, and he had 53 years of working career, and he unfortunately died of cancer, as you can see the lovely cigarette in his mouth there. So moving on here, the color theory that was behind this was all from Michael Chauvel. He is the scientist and chemist that we are grateful for that developed the color wheel, and he actually did lots of other scientific work as well, and you can research a little bit of him if you'd like to, but he wrote a treatise on describing color harmony, and this is his original color wheel that he designed based on light waves, visible light waves, but then applied that also to painting. He was born in 1786 and died in 1889, and he was 102 when he died, and he has many, many, many other different contributions he's made to society, but he was the greatest influence on Seurat that led to the idea of Neo-Impressionism. So today, as we start our Neo-Impressionism, we're going to be looking at this color wheel, and we're going to be looking at it in the sense of mixing a variety of colors. We're going to mix this color wheel here to make sure we can mix our primaries, our secondaries, and our intermediate or tertiary colors. And then we're going to use Neo-Impressionism style by making little dots in these squares to create the red orange mixes, the yellow orange mixes, these tertiary colors. Okay, so we'll look more at that in just a moment in our next video when we start actually mixing our color. And that is all about Neo-Impressionism artwork.